The views and opinions expressed by the hosts of Black Talk Radio News and any guests represents their views and their views only, and do not necessarily represent the views of the Black Talk Media Project or the Black Talk Radio Network. Scotty Reid here with a Black Talk Radio News report and commentary, and we have a story coming to you from the New York Post, which was also picked up from the Associated Press. So we have a former Navy serviceman who has been sentenced to 40 years in prison for the stabbing death of this trans person by the name of D. Wigham. This occurred last year in 2016. This man, again, has been sentenced to 40 years in prison for the stabbing death of a transgender person in Mississippi. Dwayne Hickerson, 21, pleaded guilty Thursday to murder in the killing of D. Wigham in a St. Martin hotel room on July 23rd. So, this is a tragic story on so many different levels. This person did not take it to trial. Mr. Hickerson did not go to trial, but he took a plea deal that netted him 40 years. So here's some background on the story. Mr. Hickerson met D. Wigham online, and they conversed for a time online before deciding to meet in person. When they met in person, they went straight to a hotel room. And according to Mr. Hickerson, they had some form of sex. I don't know if that was oral sex. I don't know if that was anal sex. I don't know. But it was not vaginal sex because this person, D. Wigham, doesn't have a vagina. So after they had sex, D. Wigham told Mr. Hickerson that I'm trans, meaning that I'm not a biological woman. And so Mr. Hickerson had an emotional reaction and stabbed this person. Now, we hear a lot about attacks on the LGBT community. And as I have stated in the past, I don't know the circumstances involved in all of these attacks. I do not believe in harming human beings, period. Whether or not I agree with their sexual orientation, I don't know. I don't know if these people are suffering from genetic manipulation through chemicals that are put into the food supply and the water supply. I don't know if they suffer some kind of sexual trauma, same-sex sexual trauma as children. I simply do not know, and I don't pretend to know these things, but I do know that these are human beings who have a right to life and a right to live their lives any way they want to, as long as they do not harm someone else. With that said, I do not find D. Wigham to be innocent in this. And if I was sitting on a jury and Mr. Hickerson, attorney had presented a temporary insanity defense, I would have to vote not guilty by way of temporary insanity. Now, obviously, the family members are going to be upset. For example, you have Wigham's mother, Vicky Blackney Wigham, criticizing the punishment that Mr. Hickerson received. Again, he pled guilty, I guess, to reduce charges. He entered into a plea deal that is going to get him 40 years in prison. This was a young man who was 20 years old when he met D. Wigham. He was in the United States military studying to be a meteorologist, I believe, or that was his job. And so the mother of the victim, the person that was killed, said, "I think the plea is a slap in the face," she said. "He gets a chance to see his family. I don't have that chance with my child." Okay, so I understand that this person is grieving. They have lost a child. But this person and other people out there need to realize that you cannot be engaging in sex with people, and you are not being upfront with people and telling them you are not a biological woman. Eventually, they're going to find out. And if they find that you have tricked them that you have been deceptive, then who knows what sort of emotional reaction they are going to have. So this is a tragedy on so many levels, and Mr. Hickerson is a victim himself. I can imagine what went through this man's mind after you then had sex with this individual, and then this individual, again, I don't know what type of sex, but then this individual that you were believing was a biological woman, and then after, not before, but after you have sex with this individual, they then tell you, oh, I'm trans. I'm a man transitioning to a woman. I can see somebody losing their mind in the heat of the moment and lashing out in such a manner. I'm not justifying the killing. I'm just saying I understand it. And I have seen conversations on social media about this. A person saying that, I remember, recall a post on social media where a person said, should trans people let their prospective mates, partners, people that they may date know up front what they are? And this person was kind of leaning towards not telling them up front, you know, what their sexual situation or sexual biology is. It's because then that person may not want to date them. Well, guess what? That's just a chance you're going to have to take. And there are plenty of bisexual men and homosexual men who would have sex with a trans person. So, you know, it's just no excuse for these trans people not to be telling people up front. And then you're conversing with a person online and you're representing yourself to be a biological woman, and then they have to find out later after you have had sex with them that you're not a biological woman. That's not right. You're taking away that person's ability to choose whether or not they want to be involved with you. They may, after you tell them, go right ahead and be involved with you anyway. You never know, but I don't think there is any justification for this sort of deception. I believe that it should be a crime to not let people know up front if you are a man or a woman and you're transitioning to another sex. I think that should be a crime, just like if a person does not divulge their HIV AIDS status to prospective sexual partners, they can be charged with attempted murder or manslaughter. There are a number of laws on the books that cover that. I think we need some laws on the books for trans people who are not divulging to prospective sexual partners what their status is. This ruined the life of Mr. Hickerson, and it costs this failure to divulge, cost this person, D. Wickham, their life. So those are my thoughts and opinions on this. This has been Scotty Reid with another Black Talk Radio news report. Remember, you can visit us online for more independent Black media at blacktalkradionetwork.com. Join our social network at btrcommunity.com. Follow us and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Black Talk Media. Follow us on Facebook. Subscribe to our post. That's Black Talk Radio Network on Facebook. And we're also on Twitter, and you can find us at Black Talk Radio. Continue to support the production of independent Black media by making a donation today to the U.S.-based nonprofit Black Talk Media Project. This is Scotty. I'm out. Peace.